Chairman, thank you very much for introducing me today, dear colleagues. I want to tell something about you, our experience with the new TAR2 device for thermal ablation in Thailand. I'm chairman of the German Society of Thermal Ablation. Our society was founded 2014 to supporting a change between the international medical doctors. Our center has a unique range of different techniques like monopolar, bipolar RFA. We have used cooled, uncooled mono microwave ablation. We have laser, also we have HIFU. In 2017, the largest health insurance company in Germany has recognized us as a leader in high-end medicine for nodules. And in July 2019, we start with our first experience with the new TAR2 microwave systems in vivo and ex vivo imaging. So, what is microwave? You have to know that if we work with microwave, we have always a comet tail in microwave. Therefore, you have to be careful. But microwave is very strong. And the advantages of microwave is that we have a homogeneous ablation zone, so we can distinguish treated and non-treated tissue. The performance is very well, it's constant, so we have better predictability. We have a low heating effect, therefore we have a low recurrence rates for hot nodules, thyroid nodules. And we have a high temperature, so we can work very fast, we can treat very fast large thyroid nodules. If you compare it with radio frequency ablation, we have to know that there are two different techniques. We have monopolar radio frequency and we have bipolar radio frequency. And the active tip of monopolar the ionic flow is between the active tip and the other pole. The pole can be the legs. And in bipolar RFA, we have two poles inside the nodule, so the ionic flow is only inside the nodule. In other cases, we can also use laser. To use for laser, you need a coaxial needle. So, what is the limitations of RFA? At first, we have to show what kind of shot techniques exist. We have a moving shot technique and we have the multiple overlapping shot technique. You have to know that with moving shot technique, with monopolar RFA, we have a very small area with high ionic flow because the active tip is until 10 to 50 millimeters. If you treat with monopolar RFA the tissue, you will have a high resistance in the tissue, so this will interrupt your ionic flow. Therefore, you have to move always the probe. You can ask me why you don't use bigger active tips, larger active tips. That's not possible, because to have a thermal ablation effect with monopolar, with large monopolar active tip, you need more ionic flow, you need more power. The distance between the two poles, between the thyroid and the legs, the other pole, is too far. So you need to have between 100 to 200 watts energy power to treat them. But the ionic flow is through the vessel and through the nerves, and the patient doesn't tolerate because it's very painful. Therefore, we have a technical limitation of monopolar RFA. Therefore, you have to move always the probe. If we use bipolar RFA or if we use microwave, the ionic flow or the excitation of the dipole compounds from microwave is only in the nodule. Therefore, we can use short tips or larger tips. We can treat very well small thyroid nodules or very large thyroid nodules with 4-6 centimeter diameter. And you have no grounding pads. This means that you have no risk for skin burns. It is so that the Italian opinion statement and the Korean recommendation of the interventional radiology recommended only monopolar radio frequency ablation. And this is, I think it's wrong, because they recommended only what they use. But they don't compare their own technique with the other technique like microwave or laser or bipolar RFA. And this is not right, I think. And this should be changed. You can see that if you compare the published papers between the moving shot technique and with the multiple overlapping shot technique, you will have for both the same volume reduction between 30 to 70%. But there's a main difference. If you read the paper very careful, you will see that the colleagues which published the moving shot technique treated the same patient for several times in two or three sessions. If you read the papers with the multiple overlapping shot technique, you can see that we have the same result after one session. Here you can see the difference between microwave and RFA. You can see that microwave is very strong. It's faster than RFA. You can see the bubbles. If we compare the results between microwave and water frequency, we have no many different significant difference between the volume reduction or energy transmission. But you need less shots for microwave than RFA. And the reposition frequency, the shots, is associated with an increased rate of complications. Therefore, it's better to use a system where you have more power. This is the electromagnetic field and the terminal field. The difference is that all manufacturers promise you an ellipsoid field, but that's not true. You have to know that you have always a commutative effect. Therefore, we checked the system and we use therefore a tissue mimicking phantom which has a same conductivity, thermal conductivity like thyroid. And you can see here we have a conductivity of 0.5 for thyroid and 0.59 for the tissue mimicking phantom. Therefore, we can transfer the results of the tartar microwave thermal ablation of phantom to human treated tissue in solid nodules. We have checked the both probes or antennas, 70 gauge and 18 gauge. 18 gauge is, I know that's the only microwave system for thyroid ablation now on the market. And here you can see that we have different have different morphological tiny nodules and with the same probe. And you can see that in cystic and in solid nodules, we need more time to have the same volume. Therefore, one advantage is that we can use the same probe for all kinds of thyroid nodules, but you have to know that you need less energy if you treated pre-mixed thyroid nodules or cystic nodules. So, you can see we have larger, faster effects in this tissue mimicking phantoms. Here you can see the in vivo testing of the different thyroid nodules. You can see that in the mixed thyroid nodules, we have the distribution of micro bubbles is faster than in larger thyroid nodules at the same power, because the water content of mixed thyroid nodules is higher than in solid nodules. But you can see in the solid nodules that we can distinguish, can different treated and untreated area very well. Here you can see that we can control the ablation volume with the same probe. You can see that with that we treated with 20 watts and with 30 watts. You can see it's faster to treat with 30 watts. We have more power. You can treat and control the volume what you need for thyroid nodule. Here you can see a video where we treated in front of our center. The first step is disinfection, then only local anesthesia to the skin. We not work with higher drugs, only local anesthesia. Then a tip in the skin. Then you choose the probe Put the probe into the nodule in the center part at the beginning. You can control all steps by ultrasound imaging. Then you can plan with the chart protocol for solid nodules the volume you need, with time and with the power, with what?
Ich spreche jetzt mal auf Englisch, auf den Schmerznamen, ja?
And can see the bubbles in the thyroid nodule. This is an old patient protocol, what we use in our center. You can remove at the end of the treatment. So, if you compare radiofrequency, microwave, laser, and HIFU, they all showed comparable results considering volume reduction. So, why we should use tartar microwave? The answer is, if you compare only volume reduction, it's okay. But 50% of our patient has hot, hyperfunctional thyroid nodules, and this makes a difference. Because you have to know that we have more recurrence rates on hot thyroid nodules if we treat with RFA, because the heat sink effect is bigger. Now you have more energy loss with RFA if you compare it with microwave. Therefore, for hot thyroid nodules or for big, large, non-functional thyroid nodules, it's better to treat with microwave. This is a follow-up. You can see that the ablation zone of RFA is very blurry, it's hard and suspicious. And if we use the thyroid, the TRADS reposing system, the risk for months is up to 35%. If you compare it with microwave, you have very sharp area, and you know that this is relating to illness caused by medical examination or treatment. We know that some patients have been mistakenly operated unnecessarily by thyroid surgeons. So, you can use the TARTU microwave chart protocol for solid nodules. You can see that we have the same ablated area in vivo and ex vivo. So you can predict the energy you needed. And for the monitoring of the therapy, it's very important because the energy transmission is an important parameter in addition to the ultrasound. So you can use for solid nodules the chart protocol, and therefore you have an effective, safe, and suitable terminal ablative technique. So here's one session with another microwave ablation systems already. With microwave, you can treat very large nodules, and we have very nice results. You have no volume limit. If we compare our results with the Italian opinion, they recommended only treatment of 25 milliliters volumes of thyroid hot nodules. But with microwave, you can treat also hot nodules, thyroid nodules, up to 80 milliliters. Why should we treat it? Why should we treat hot thyroid nodules? Because if you treat a hot thyroid nodule, the risk for hypothyroidism is 0.001. If you treat the same patient with radioactive therapy, the risk for hypothyroidism is more than 70% after 10 years. Therefore, he will have a lifelong administration of synthetic thyroid hormones. And this, the synthetic thyroid hormones, is correlated with higher risk for cardiac mortalities, dementia, and 50% in case of osteoporosis. Therefore, you should treat primarily hot thyroid nodules with thermal ablation instead of radiotherapy. So this is our statement, which we published in 2018 in the Ultrasound and Medicine Biology from the World Federation. And we recommended that the choice of local ablative thermal treatment depends only on local expertise. You can treat with monopolar RFA or bipolar RFA or with microlaser. You can make it. But you have to know that you have a technical limitation with the other systems. These are some complications which we have in our center. We use in former times other devices, and the antennas from the other devices was designed for liver. Now we have a well-designed microwave system for thyroid to avoid these kinds of complications. We can avoid skin burns, hematomas, but of course you need training, you need workshop, and you need life intervention support. Take-home message is the only 18 gauge antenna specifically designed for third ablation is from Tattoo. In 20 patients treated with the last 3 months, we have no complications. The use of Tattoo mercury is an effective and safe suitable technique, but training and practice make perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, you are all invited to visit us in our center in Frankfurt. You can come, you can see all kinds of the ablation techniques. You can see RFA, microwave, laser, HIFU. You need support if you want to start. Thank you very much for your attention.